Hello, hello, hello. Here follow the solutions to problem 243. They're written up by Keith Norman, but he is using the solutions by Ulf Heller. The letters may be a bit small, but I will read them. He writes, I cannot find this exact situation in Walter's 802 lectures, but he introduces magnetism in detail in lectures 11, 13, 14, and 15 of 802. In lecture 14, at about 13 minutes into the lecture, he compares B fields at a large distance from a current loop with E fields at a large distance from an electric dipole, and notes the similar shape of the field lines. This is key to solving the problem. Ulf Heller and Virgin Tamperamos have almost identical solutions. Ulf Heller's solution follows. We have two identical circular loops of radius A, separated by R much larger than A. I cannot see it is given that the currents in the two loops are equal, so I will call them I1 and I2. The magnetic dipole moments are then, and you see them, at the distance r along the axis, the field of dipole M1 is, and you see that. The potential interaction energy is, and there it is. Substituting the dipole moments, M1 and M2. That leads to U and then he gets very close to the final answer, F is dUdr. The negative sign means attraction of the two loops. Virgin Tamperamos treats the currents as identical given. In other words, he assumes that I1 equals I2. And then he finds this answer. Was this difficult? Maybe it was. Would I have been able to do this in high school? Probably not. I'll make the next problem, 244, a little easier. And I will post that probably in about a week. Oh, by the way, the number of people that have the correct answers is about 5.